Hello everyone, in this video we are going to address dyslexia from a spiritual angle. Okay, so let's start off with the medical definition. It says, caused mostly by discrepancies in the processing of sounds and spoken language by the brain, usually transposing of letters, usually found in the parents and grandparents as well. Root cause. Generational. Could be an inversion of God's order in the home, matriarchal control rather than patriarchal authority. Consequences could be self-rejection, self-hatred, and guilt. Interferes with self-esteem. Relevant scripture. John 14:26. The Holy Spirit shall teach you all things and bring things to your remembrance. Daniel 1:17. God gave them knowledge and skill in all learning and wisdom. Psalm 146:8. The Lord opens the eyes of the blind. The Lord raises those who are bowed down. The Lord loves the righteous. Isaiah 35:5. Then the eyes of the blind shall be opened, and the ears of the deaf shall be unstopped. Isaiah 50:4. The Lord God has given me the tongue of the learned, that I should know how to speak a word in season to him who is weary. He awakens me morning by morning. He awakens my ear to hear as the learned. Okay, and then ministry, how to address dyslexia. And everything is always in Jesus' name. Command all the neurological cells of the brain to come under the control of Jesus Christ and function normally with balanced levels of serotonin and dopamine. Minister the love and acceptance of the Father God. Command clarity, focus, and concentration abilities to come forth. Apply the anointing to break off the yoke of bondage and any mind-binding spirit. If there had been any involvement by them or their parents or relative in the occult, renounce and ask God to forgive them for that involvement and close any doors, access to them or their thinking patterns, and seal that opening with the blood of the Lamb. Call forth the plans and purposes of God that was not to harm them, and bring forth their destiny in God. Call forth life, and life more abundantly. Quote John 3:17 and proclaim that word of life over them and their future. And John 3:17 says, for God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. So everything I just read in this ministry section, you're going to, you know, do all of that in the name of Jesus, of course. And again, this pretty much applies to everything. So every video that I'm going to do regarding specific topics, again, you know, there's just basic things that we need to do that would really address so many things all at once. We need to forgive ourselves, God, and others. We need to repent of our sins. We need to renounce our sins. We need to revoke, let me go backwards. We need to renounce not only our sins, but our ancestors' sins. And we need to repent of them, renounce them, revoke them, break the yoke, invite the Holy Spirit, forbid retaliation from the enemy, so on and so forth. Pretty much the steps that I call the prayerful steps to freedom. You want to, you know, announce that you're entering into God's court, his courtroom. You want to address God as judge. I will put resources and links to all of that below in the description box for your reference. But if we just address these things spiritually, if we forgive and we repent on our behalf and our ancestors' behalf, we renounce, we revoke, we break the yokes, so on and so forth, that pretty much across the board addresses all kinds of stuff. You know, I'm making these videos for each little condition, and it gives little insights and stuff. As to what, you know, that can point you in the direction of, like, you know, to examine things, to observe things, to ask the Holy Spirit about certain things of, you know, whether or not there needs to be certain, you know, particular repentance for particular things and forgiveness and so on and so forth. So that's why I'm doing this. So I will put all of that stuff below, and I bless you all in Jesus' name.